I have not been good at it before. Those of you in the audience with issues of a photosensitive nature, this is your official warning to turn away from this game now. Having said that, hey, what's up, people of the internet? I'm Anorak from Anorak Gaming Studios, where we're all gaming all the time. Welcome back to Assassin's Creed 2 as part of the Assassin's Creed Ezio Collection. Last time we left off, we were in the midst of going to track down Viare de Pazzi. Oh, and an apology to any Italian speakers for the names I'm about to butcher here. So, let's get into it. Rebecca, can you please load me out of the memory corridor? Okay. First off. Always get the sync points. Hup. Oh, they're upstairs. Yeesh. Right.
Ezio, look at her. I still can't get her to talk. She spends all day and night in front of those feathers Petruccio used to collect. She can't let them go. I don't know what to do.
Don't worry. She'll come back to us. I know it.
All right. Hup. That's gonna be of interest. Am I doing the easiest way down is just to do the leap of faith again. Yep. I figured that it hurt more than it did. Ability to make my health slightly better is not going to cause me problems. However, may. Okay. Mario?
Ezio, what are you doing here?
Taking responsibility. Vieri troubles you because of me.
Vieri troubles us because he's a Templar, and we are assassins.
Either way, I wish to help.
Va bene. Then listen close. First, we must find a way inside the city, though it seems Vieri expects us. He has sealed the gates and sent his men to guard them. Fortunately for us, the city is larger than its host. The southern gate suffers, so this is where we'll strike. Pronti? Alright, Ezio. Here's how it is going to work. My men and I will distract the guards. Once we have engaged them, get yourself over the wall and find a way to open the gates. Take these throwing knives. Use them to dispatch the archers.
I'm ready when you are.
Then let us begin. All'attacco!
Easy enough.
Well done, Ezio. We are in. This way, man. I want you to distract those guards and keep them from raising the alarm. Hopefully, it will buy me enough time to find and silence Vieri.
Va bene.
Wait, Nipote. Take a few of my men with you, just to be safe. Come join me once they're dealt with.
What's Vieri up to now?
No one knows, but something has him on edge. How else to explain all the patrols?
Signal again when you should follow.
Instead, he's turned us into nursemaids. And what?
Shooting his mouth off again, no doubt. Angering the wrong sorts of people. And so now, we pay the price.
Careful. Before he played Granado
once. So I heard
the I'd like to keep mine. So let's end this conversation.
Is he
See, I told you photosensitive people should probably not be watching this.
Send you to hell.
Ezio, your uncle's under attack and needs help. Go to him.
Brothers and I will deal with these guys. I want you to go on ahead and root out that snake. See that justice is served.
A great metal work here.
It's settled. Ieri, you will remain here to coordinate the mercenary. Francesco will organize our forces in the city and send word when it's time to strike. Jacopo, your job is to calm the citizens once the deed is done.
What of that Ubriacone Mario? He continues to harass my forces, and I fear he'll discover what we intend.
He's always been troubled, just like that bastardo brother of his.
Then let me reunite them, father.
There will be plenty of time to clean up the refute when we're finished. Now, is there anything else? Muy bien. May the Father of Understanding guide you.
May the Father of Understanding guide you.
Commandante! Commandante!
What?
Mario Auditore has invaded the city. He comes for you.
Then let's not keep him waiting.
What are you and your allies planning? Is this what my father discovered? Is this why he was killed?
I'm sorry. Were you hoping for a confession?
Pezzo di merda! Vorrei solo che avesse sofferto di più! Hai avuto la fine che meritavi! Spero che brutto!
Enough, Ezio! Show some respect.
Respect? After all that's happened, do you think he would have shown either of us such kindness?
You are not Fieri. Do not become him. Che la morte ti dia le pace che cercavi. Requiesca in pace. Take this. Read it when you have the time. Our work here is finished. Let us return to the villa.
Traditional remedy. Farewell and swift recovery, amico.
again, please.
Starting the celebration.
And why not? You've done us a great service, Nipote. With Vieri dead, La Toscana will grow quiet once more. Do you know what that means?
Basta lavorare.
Si passa tutto il giorno a bere.
E a puttane. What? It's true.
Come, Ezio. Walk with me.
Yes, uncle. The Pazzi answer to another. Spaniard.
He is Rodrigo Borgia, one of the most powerful men in all of Europe, and leader of the Templar Order.
Which makes him responsible for the murder of my father and brothers.
Yes, and he will kill you too, given the chance.
Then I must stand against him if I wish to be free. But not until every other Templar has fallen to my blade. Father's least will guide me.
Where will you go next?
Firenze. Francesco de Pazzi will share the fate of his son.
A sensible next step. No doubt he intends evil for the city. All right. That's enough grim talk for one night. I'll be in my study if you need me.
I shall read the letter my uncle gave me.
Familiar?
Codex pages.
Yes. Your father managed to find and translate a few for him.
Here.
This is not your father's work. Someone else has translated it.
Leonardo da Vinci, a friend.
Do you see the way the words cross from one page to the next?
There is something underneath it all. Kind of map. Is it supposed to lead?
Your father and I managed to make out bits of a prophecy scrawled across these pages. It was written by an assassin like us, who long ago held a piece of Eden. His name was Altair. He spoke of something powerful and ancient hidden in the land.
What is it?
What indeed? Solving that little mystery is exactly why we collected these pages.
Then let me help. It's time I take on my father's work. All of it. Start with the page I took from Vieri. Leonardo will decode it for us.
Bene. Return here when time permits, and we'll add it to the wall.
That's one. Final one is outside the city walls, right there. I knew that would probably hurt.
You should feel better now. Take care.
I prefer not to use the medicines if I don't have to.
Yeah.
here. I am gonna swing around. This map so confusing. Ah. So I am headed the right way.
Salute, Claudia.
Our uncle is un mostro. This is outrageous.
What's happened?
He's making me work. If father was here, I'd never be stuck behind a desk like this.
And what are the terms of this supposed enslavement?
Since someone decided we're going to stay here, Zio Mario suggested we try and find the money to repair the villa. Problem is, there isn't any.
I bet I can bring in some money.
Oh, great. More work for me. Well, benissimo. If you start paying for improvements to the town, I'll keep track of them in this book. And since I have nothing better to do, I'll also make note of any objects you bring in from the outside. If you actually get this place up and running, travelers might visit and spend money. Although I doubt anyone will want to come this far out of the city. But if they do, I'll keep the money we make in this chest. You're going to have to show up to take it to the bank yourself. Because when it gets full, I'm just going to take the extra cash for myself. Capito?
Dio. Buongiorno. Is there something wrong?
Ser Mario hired me to deal with this mess, but I'm an architetto, not a miracle worker. Without money, I can't fix any of these buildings.
And if someone brought you money?
And then we'd be in business. You must be Ser Ezio. Am I right?
Uncle, I like this architetto.
He gets very observant when he can spell money.
If you want to fix up this town, I'm going to need it. I have a price list here for new shops and renovations. Just bring me gold, make a choice, and I'll begin at once. If I build you a shop, you, as the landlord, can purchase goods there at lower rates. If you invest more money in the shop, you get an even greater discount. As for renovations, well, you'll be bringing the town and villa back to life. As Ser Mario tells me, that was very important to your great-great-grandfather. Plus, when you buy shops and renovations, you'll be increasing the number of people who visit, causing your income to increase. So, let's take a look, shall we?
Buon viaggio!
That's going to be it from me. Anorak out.